What up? Changanga. Welcome back to another episode of Wednesday Night Smack Talk. And here we are on episode 193 of Wednesday Night Smack Talk. Now, next week on 194, we will be live predicting Royal Rumble. Very quick turnaround from day one, but that's of course why the day one tournament happened. I've already explained all that. And we already have a bunch of matches laid out for the Rumble. And tonight, we're gonna delve a little bit further into the build for some matches that we already know about, and some cool announcements about one particular match that of course is the namesake. But first, I want to go over the tag team championship match because I am in that. I don't really have much more to say. I've been fighting, scratching, clawing, and biting my own fingernails. That's just something I do as a hobby, but it still is something I was doing to get a match for the tag team championships. The ones that Joe, and I lost months ago now. Clean, fairly, but we should get a rematch. And we've been asking for a while, and now we finally got it. And I want to say, thankfully, there is no Hunter Hogan or Franco promo saying that, wait a minute, brother, we are not going to do this match. I can officially tell you, the contract behind the scenes has been signed. The match is happening at the Royal Rumble. Now, that's all I want to delve into on that. I just want everybody to know that. It's important to me, so it should be important to you. Now, speaking of matches that are also important to me, we have the TV Championship match, a rematch between Mikey and El Tequito Valente. El Tequito Valente, the greatest TV champion in the history of TV champions. Of course, there's only like three, but you can't argue he's the best. I mean, it's just not, it's inarguable. Mikey's got a chance to beat that, though, because Mikey is the TV champion, and he is giving Tequito a rematch. But last week, Tequito asked for Big Man to be a special guest enforcer because he claims that Mikey, yet again at day one, impersonated Tequito. And he said, if Kane can't tell the difference, and I guess Tequito's too scared to stand up for himself, then he'll have the Bennett Man come in there and do it for him. Now, I'm not necessarily opposed to this. I'm not necessarily for it either. I don't really care. But it's not up to me to decide. I let my good friend, my good pal, my older brother, Mikey, tell it how it is. So, go ahead, Mike.
Hello, everybody. It's Mikey Carbs, your TV champion, your day one predictions winner, and sit tight. We got a lot to talk about. So, first, I listened last week and I heard Tequito again with these accusations, how I impersonated him. He wants to bring in Bennett Man. I don't understand what it is whenever I'm champion that everybody feels like they could just make demands at me and I should accept them. Do you remember last year's WrestleMania with Darcy? He had a list of demands. I don't know what it is. Why does now Tequito has demands? I'm ready to clear this up once and for all. This is my Tequito impression. Hello, Ziz. My name is the Tequito. Does that sound like who's been impersonating Tequito, if he's even been impersonated? This is all an elaborate ruse that everybody is bought into. I'm so sick of people saying that I'm guilty of this. It is so, I don't even know how to handle it. Is this how OJ felt? The innocent man OJ? Where everybody kept saying, well, you're guilty, but the people found him innocent? So this is what it is. Am I the OJ of this league? I just don't get it. I don't know you guys are persecuting an innocent man here. Hold on. I would like the Bidneth Manses to be the special enforcers. Does that sound like the voice? That's my Tequito impression. I don't get it. Whatever. To answer his request, because, like I said, when I'm champion, everybody has fucking requests. I don't think I accept. I will let Business Man be there. But the King Man should be there too. Because I remember a certain match between the two about who has hosting duties. And, you know, the Golden Gods were only fair. I think it's only fair to let King be the person doing the announcing because that's what he won. That's what he deserves. He's better at it than Business Man, sorry. But because we're fair, I will allow Business Man to be at least 20 feet away from me, at least. He could be next to Taquito. But as long as he's away from me, he could be in the room. And in case he hears, I would like the Roman Reigns's, and he thinks it's not Taquito saying that, then he could speak up. But he is not going to be the one in charge. I'm sick of these people giving me demands. So that's about that. But we have a whole other thing. Because I mentioned I am the TV champion, and I'm the day one predictor winner. And people that stayed up the full 24 hours, they got their choice. And God, of course, I understand how two of the three people are fucking idiots. Why would you compete for a chance to compete when you could compete for the chance for the title itself? Does not make sense to me. And especially because it took two out of the three idiots, that title match went from a one-on-one when it really should have been a fatal four-way for the belt. So, Lou, you're a genius. I mean, I know we have a little bit of a, you know, storied past here, but you are the only one with brains, and because you have brains going against other people that have no brains, your brains got rewarded for a one-on-one match. To talk about Franco, you know, he's only challenging me because of the past history, you know, because I beat him in the first match. You gotta let it go. I don't know what else to tell you. I mean, I keep beating you. It's not like you ever beat me, so I don't know which point in history you're mad about me beating you, but I beat you every single time. So let it go. I believe you could fly. You remember that song from when you lost the first time I beat you? Exactly. Let it go. But you chose to make this a triple threat, which is so fucking stupid, and it pisses me off so much. And then there's Sebi. For Sebi, he doesn't have great luck. For Sebi, I can understand why he did it. Because a one-on-one match without the 3 points, Sebi's been on quite a losing streak. He is gambling on the chance for that plus three. Franco, you've been on quite a winning streak. You don't need the plus three. So for Sebi, I understand. But whatever. Triple threat, it doesn't matter. I'll beat you both. I mean, Lou, congratulations. You got a one-on-one match. You got your first victory in the post-COVID era, and you're being rewarded for it. So God bless you. But that I just give up. I don't know. I can't. Here's my thing. If I'm going to have to go and defend this day one victory, I haven't talked to King about it, but I don't know. I'll let him, that when this ends, I'll let him tell me the decision because I haven't talked to him about it. I would like to be in the Royal Rumble match as well. So since we're announcing candidates today, maybe I've just announced myself as the first candidate. I don't know. We'll let King answer in about 3, 2, 1.
No. I'm sorry, Mikey. I got the people for the Rumble, and listen. While I like the Golden Gods winning a lot, being a Golden God, I don't know if I can have you win the Rumble, the Day One tournament, and be TV champion. That's just I'm booking myself short there at that point. No, he's not in the Rumble, everyone. You can breathe a sigh of relief because no, Mike, he's not gonna win the Rumble again. Because he's not in it. He'll be defending the TV title. And Bit of Man, you're allowed to be there, so congratulations. Not necessarily special guest enforcer, but you can pipe up if you hear some things happening that are dubious. But if not, keep your mouth shut when you're around us, the Golden Gods. Either way, we'll see that match. Well, we'll see it, of course, next week. And speaking of another match we'll see next week, we have the main event. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, the main event of Royal Rumble. Zach, the champion, of course, versus Lou, who made a choice between Mikey at WrestleMania for the 24/7 challenge opportunity, or Zach just for the title at Royal Rumble. And Lou was the only one to choose Zach, which means they have a one-on-one match in the main event. And of course, Lou chose it last week. Zach now would like to respond in kind and give his thoughts on his opponent and his match at the Royal Rumble. So, Zach, go ahead, pal.
Excuse me for a second. I didn't realize you were coming in today. Well, I'm glad you're here anyway, because I've got some great news. I have an opponent for the Royal Rumble. And it's not Brandon. It's not Brandon, thank God. Yes! Brandon, if I had to face you one more time, I would walk out of this company. I would take the Predictions Championship with me. I would bring it to the Fightgeist, and you'd never see me again. You would have no Predictions Champion. You would have no championship. This league would fall through. So thank God that I wasn't pushed to that. Because you don't want to push me to that. Trust me. You don't want to see me like that. Anyway, I'm facing Lou! Yay! I'm facing Lou! I like Lou. A great choice. I'm glad you picked me. It'll be a great match. Yeah, I'm excited. It's not really much more I have to say. I don't really have a beef with you. I'm just happy to be facing someone who isn't Brandon. Thank God it's not Brandon. Anyone but you. So Lou, I'll see you at the Rumble. And good luck. Because Hogan knows best.
Well, I can definitely tell you that as long as it was anybody other than Brandon, Zach would have been perfectly fine with the match. I think Zach's ex-girlfriend could have been in that match and he would have been happy. I mean, Brandon, I'm sorry to tell you, I don't know if you're ever going to get that match against Zach for the title. But Lou, you are. And he may be looking a little bit past you, you know. He's kind of, he talked about you a little bit, but you know, he's kind of focused on somebody else. Maybe now, in the year of Lou, starting, of course, last year, but continuing on at the beginning of the year, maybe the year of Lou starts at the Royal Rumble. We'll have to see. But, of course, speaking about the Royal Rumble, ladies and gentlemen, last week I told you that I would announce the people in the match. This week, I'm announcing it. The people in the match. I saved the Royal Rumble entrance for last. These are the people that will enter the Royal Rumble. And the winner, of course, goes on in the annals of history as one of the great winners of the KKPL Royal Rumble. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to reveal the people in the match. So, enjoy this. Here you go. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Those are our six competitors in the Royal Rumble match. They will all receive five numbers via wheel spin that correlate to actual Royal Rumble entrants. And, well, whoever's got the number of the corresponding Royal Rumble entrant that wins the actual Royal Rumble in real life they win our Royal Rumble. If you didn't know the rules by now, after 4 years of it. Either way, we'll have to see all that next week on Wednesday Night SmackDown. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching, liking, commenting, subscribing, and turning on notifications so you can notify whenever another one of these comes out, or anything else you want to see on the channel for that matter. And that's all I got for you this week, but next week, you don't want to miss the live predicting of the Royal Rumble. Now, I won't keep you any longer, so get, you hear? Go on, get! Get out of here, get! Yeah!
THANKYOU, thank you, thank you. THANKYOU.
Thank you.